Hi, I'm Dr. Abhishek Joshi, and in this lecture, I'm going to discuss about the Gram-Smith orthogonalization scheme. So what is Gram-Smith orthogonalization? Gram-Smith orthogonalization scheme is used to generate the orthogonal signals. And how we can generate the orthogonal signals? With the help of the orthonormal basis function. Now we'll see in this lecture how we can generate the orthogonal basis function with the help of the orthonormal basis functions. So here we can see, here we have the signal, different signals given by SI1i, SI2, SIN. Okay. And these are the orthonormal basis functions given by phi1t, phi2t up to phi nt. And we are actually multiplying these orthonormal basis functions and then we are summing it and transmitting it from the transmitter. So this is a concept of the general modulator, as we can think. So this is a synthesizer for generating the signal, that is SIT, and the B part, this part is showing the analyzer for generating the set of the signals vectors. Means again at the demodulator side, or you can say the receiver side, again we are splitting it the signals. So we are getting a signal that is SIT, and we are multiplying again with the same carrier, or we can say the basis function phi1t, phi2t and up to phi nt. So the product, and then we are passing through the filter, or you can say the low pass filter. We are getting the splitting these signals, that is SIT, S1, S2, SIN. So up to SI1, SI2, up to SIN, we'll be having different message point or signals. So we can write in mathematics that SIT is given by, that is summation j equals to I to n Sij phi j t, where the value of t is varying from the 0 to t, and I is an integer which holding the value 1, 2, 3 up to m, where the coefficients of expansion, because this Sij is given by, or it can be solved with the help of, that is integration from 0 to t SIT phi j t dt. So we can easily solve it, and we can substitute in this expression, we will get the signal SIT, where I and j, I is again an integer holding the values 1, 2, 3 up to m. So there are m number of signals, okay, and basis function is given by with a subscript j. So j is showing the number of the orthonormal basis functions. So basis functions again is a holding integer value, that is j equals to 1, 2, 3 up to n. So there are m number of signals and n number of orthonormal basis functions. So there are n basis functions and m number of signals. So these two things we have to remember. Based on these, we will substitute the values and we will solve for the orthonormal basis functions. So the real valued basis function, that is given by phi1t, phi2t up to phi nt, are orthonormal, by which we mean, so we can say that if we are saying the two vectors or two functions are orthonormal, means they are forming an angle of 90 degree between them. So when I'm saying that two signals, that is S1 and S2, is normal to each other, so the product, or you can say the dot product, will be given by S1 dot S2. What I can write, that is S1 S2 cos of theta. This means theta is here 90 degree. So if theta is 90 degree, cos 90 will be equals to 0. So product will be given by, so I can write here S1 into S2 cos of 90, which is equals to 0. So this means the dot product will be equals to 0 when I am saying there are two different orthonormal basis function, that is phi1 and phi2. Okay, we can name it as phi1, phi2, we can name it as any other. So for generalized notation, we are denoting these functions by phi1 and phi2, phi3, phi4. Okay. Just for the explanation, I have chosen only two functions, phi1, phi2. There may be more number of functions depending on the number of signals. So here we can see we have the integration from 0 to t, phi i t into phi j t. This means if we are having two different orthonormal basis functions, we can write it as, that is del ij. So del ij is equals to 1. If we are saying it is 1, then this means I equals to j, and we are saying that it is equals to 0 when I is not equals to j. So when we are saying that two orthonormal functions are same, for example, if we have phi 1 here and it is same, means j is equals to I, then again it is phi 1. So it means the angle between the two basis functions which are exactly same, that is phi 1 and phi 1, will be equals to theta, will be equals to 0. So dot product will be phi 1 phi 2 cos of 0. Cos 0 is 1, so we will get the phi 1 and phi 2, and we know that the energy of orthonormal basis function is equals to 1. So this means this dot product will be phi 1 into phi 1, so it will become phi 1 square. So phi 1 square integration, if you integrate, the energy will be equals to 1. So this is the speciality of orthonormal basis function. So we can write the signals that is given by SI. We are having different components of this SI, that is SI1, SI2 up to SIN, where the value of I is varying from 1, 2, 3 up to M because of M number of signals. So if we have M number of signals, there will be value of I that is varying from 1 to M. So the first orthonormal set of the basis function is given by, so we can find the first basis function simply using the formula, that is phi I t, or you can say phi 1 t, that is given by S 1 t divided by energy of under root the energy of S 1 t. So these are the formulas which we have to remember to solve the numericals. So we have, where we have this E 1 is the energy of the signal. So energy of the signal is given by S 1 t. So we can write that S 1 t simply by cross multiplying it, we are getting, that is phi 1 t multiplied by under root of E 1, we will get our signal, that is the first signal S 1 t. So this means when we are multiplying it, this is nothing but the component S 1 1 into phi 1. So S 1 1 here is equals to under root of its energy, where the coefficient of S 1 1. So coefficient of S 1 1 is under root of energy, as we have discussed. And phi 1 has the unit energy as required. So next, using the signal S2, so now for the next signal S2, we have to find the orthonormal basis function for our second signal. So we define the coefficient, that is S21. So S21 is given by, that is integration from 0 to t S2t into phi 1 t dt, where phi 1 is the same function which we have calculated here using this formula. So we can calculate S21, okay, or it is nothing but S21 stands for the projection of the S2 vector, projection of S2 over S1. So when we are finding the projection of S2 over S1, so we know that the orthonormal basis function for S1 is given by phi 1. Orthonormal basis function for S2 will be here, that is normal to phi 1, and it is here. So we have to find the orthonormal basis function. So we have to find the projection of S2 on S1, and then we have to find phi 2. So this is the procedure we have to follow, and this procedure is followed to find different orthonormal basis function, that is phi 1, phi 2, phi 3 up to phi n. If we have m number of signals, so we will be having two different cases, we'll discuss in next slide. So we may thus introduce a new intermediate function. So new intermediate function is given by g2t, because for the second function or second signal s2t, we will find the second intermediate function, that is g2t, that is s2t minus s21 phi 1t. So which is orthonormal or orthogonal to phi 1. So this is intermediate function is orthogonal to the function or the basis function phi 1 t, ranging from 0 to t by the virtue of the equation, that is the fact that the basis function phi 1 t has a unit energy. So we can find the second orthonormal basis function given by, that is phi 2 t is given by g 2 t divided by energy of g 2 t. So under root the energy of g 2 t, this means under root of integration from 0 to t g 2 square t dt. So this is the formula for finding the second orthonormal basis function. Now substituting the equation and simplifying, we are getting, so we are getting the second orthonormal basis function by substituting the value of g2 here from this equation. It is given by g2 is equals to s2t minus s21 phi 1t. So we have this phi 2t that is given by s2t minus s21 phi 1t divided by under root e2 minus s21 square, where e2 is the energy of the signal, that is s2t, and it is clear from the equation that that is integration from 0 to t phi 2 square t dt is equals to 1. So this means energy of orthonormal basis function will be equals to 1, means either it will be phi 1, it will be phi 2, it will be phi 3, any orthonormal basis function it may be. The energy, if you are finding the energy of third orthonormal basis function, it will be also equals to 1. So this means if you find the energy, then it will be equals to 1. So we can write, if you have two different orthonormal basis function given by phi 1, phi 2, an angle between phi 1 and phi 2 is 90 degree. So the dot product we can find for these two vectors, the dot product is given by phi 1 into phi 2 cos of 90 degree. This means it will be equal to cos 90 will be 0. So product will be equal to 0. So here we can write, that is integration from 0 to t phi 1 t into phi 2 t dt is equal to 0. So this is to say that that is the phi 1t and phi 2t form an orthonormal pair as required. Continuing in this fashion, we can generally define, we can define the intermediate function. So this is the important formula, or this is the general formula which we have to remember. Here we can substitute the different values of I ranging from 1, 2, 3. But for initial value, we don't have this component. So this component will be equals to 0 for value of I equals to 1, only you have git is equals to sit, and then further you can solve. And another component, so component sij we have to find. So the coefficient, that is sij, is defined by, that is integration from 0 to t sit phi jt dt, and value of j is ranging from j is equals to 1, 2, 3 up to I minus 1. So we have sij given by integration from 0 to t sit phi jt, and value of j is ranging from the integers, that is 1, 2, 3 up to I minus, because initial value we are not taking. So it is a special case of the equation for I equals to 2, means we are not taking I equals to 1, because I have seen already discussed that this component will be equals to 0 for the I equals to 1. So note that for I equals to 1, git reduces to sit. Given that git, we may define the set of the orthonormal basis function given by phi it, that is equals to git divided by under root of its energy, under root of integration from 0 to t gi square t dt, and I is ranging from 1, 2, 3 up to n. So we will be having two different cases when we solve for different signals. The dimension n, so n is given for number of orthonormal basis function, is less than or equal to the number of signals. For example, we can write n is less than equals to m, depending on one of the two possibilities. So what is the possibility? So if signals s1t, s2t, s3t up to smt form a linearly independent set, means the any of these signals are not forming the third signal, then we will say these signals are linearly independent. So in which case n equals to m. So if signals are linearly independent, means you cannot form one equation from or one signal from another signal simply by multiplying, adding or subtracting or any mathematical operation, then we can say that the signals are linearly independent. So this is the important check we have to check every time while forming the orthonormal basis functions. Now the next important thing is the signals. We have different signals s1t, s2t up to smt are not linearly independent, in which case n is less than m. This means if we have the linear combination of signals, then n will be number of orthonormal basis function n is always less than the number of the signals. So we will have to analyze that how many signals we have. If it is forming the linear combination, this means n will be less than m. So and the intermediate function, that is git, is 0 for I is greater than n. So now let's solve one example based on the concept of Gram-Smith orthogonalization procedure. So figure displays the waveform of four signals. So here we have four signals, that is S1T, S2T, S3T and S4T. Now it is given using the Gram-Smith orthogonalization procedure, find an orthonormal basis function for this set of signals and construct the corresponding signal space diagram. So this means we have to form the constellation diagram and we have to solve the orthonormal basis function. So we can see here we have four different signals, S1T, S2T, S3T and S4T. So if we analyze these signals, we can S1T is ranging from 0 to T by 3, S2T is ranging from 0 to 2T by 3 and S3T is ranging from T by 3 to T and S4T is ranging from 0 to T. So we can see that we can form the four signals simply by adding the signal 1 and signal 3. If we add signal 1 with signal 3, we will get signal 4 by analyzing the signal. This means there is a linear combination. So if we have the linear combination, we have the number of orthogonal, the number of signals are m equals to 4, but the number of orthonormal basis function will be less than 4. This means if we are talking about integers, it will be n equals to 3. So we have to find 3 orthonormal basis function by analyzing these 4 signals. Now of the first expression for the intermediate function is given by, so I am writing the first expression, that is git is given by sit minus summation j is varying from 1 to I minus 1 and sij phi j. So the coefficient, if we substitute I equals to 1 here, what we will get is, that is git is given by, because we know that when we are putting 1, you don't have this component because j is varying from 1 to 0, that is not possible. So this means as git is simply given by s1t. So we don't have to find the coefficients of sij. So we know the formula for sij, that is sij is given by integration from 0 to t si or sit phi j t. This will be the formula to find the intermediate function. So now we have to find the basis function, that is phi I t. Phi I t is given by g I t divided by the energy of g I t. Energy of g I t means 0 to t and g I square t dt. So this will be the orthonormal basis function. But here we have to substitute I equals to 1. For I equals to 1, phi 1 t is given by g 1 t divided by, or you can say s 1 t, because g 1 equals to s 1, under root of energy of g 1 t, 0 to t, g 1 square t dt. This means g 1 is equals to s 1, so I can write s 1 t divided by under root of 0 to t s 1 square t dt. So we have to simply solve the energy for s 1 t and we can easily find. So s 1 t is given by, from 0 to t by 3 we have the value, that is 1. So finding the energy of s 1 t, energy of s 1 t is given by e 1. I can write from 0 to t s 1, so value is 1 t, but the range is from 0 to, as we can see here, ranging from 0 to t by 3. So the ranging from 0 to t by 3, and this 1 square will be 1 only dt. So if you integrate, you will get t for the limit 0 to t by 3. So this means upper limit, so we substituting the upper limit, it is t by 3 minus 0, or we will get t by 3. So the energy is given by t by 3. Now substituting in the basis function phi 1 t, we will get phi 1 t is s1t, s1t value is 1, ranging from 0 to t by 3, divided by its energy. Energy is given by E1, so I will substitute here, energy is root of t by 3. So if I solve it, it will get, I will take it this in numerators by simplifying it, so it will be simply 3 by t, ranging from, because 1 multiplied by this quantity will be 3 by t, ranging from 0 to t by 3. So I can plot it in form of the function, that is phi 1 t is given by, that is root of t by 3, ranging from 0 to t by 3. So this is root of 3 by t, ranging from 0 to t by 3. So this is the first orthonormal basis function. Now the similarly, we can find the second orthonormal basis function. The second orthonormal basis function is given by, so first we have to check the equation, substituting I equals to 2 in this equation. Substituting I equals to 2, what we will get? We will get as g2t given by s2t minus summation j is equals to 1 to I minus 1 sit phi j t. So what we are getting is, we are getting, that is sij, here we have sij, so sij we have to find first. Substituting I equals to 2, we are getting s2t summation, and I equals to 2, so this means 2 minus 1 will be 1, so we will have j is also equals to 1, so s 1 1 and phi 1 t. So we already have this value of phi 1, but we have to find the coefficient of s 1 1. So coefficient of s 1 1 is given by s 1 1 according to the formula 0 to t s 1 t into phi 1 t dt. But we have seen that what is s1? S1 is ranging from 0 to 1, and we have the value, okay, here j is equals to 2, not 1, j is equals to, ranging from, the value of j is ranging from 1 to 1, so it is 1 only, and here it is phi j will be 2 here, okay. So if we have, so we have substituted only 1 here, so we have 1, so we can find s11 is given by s1, so we'll first draw s1, we'll see s1, it is ranging 1 from 0 to t by 3. Substituting s11, what is s1t? Its magnitude is 1, ranging from 0 to t by 3. And what is phi1? Phi1 is given by root t by 3, here you can see root 3 by t for the same limit 0 to t by 3. So their product will be root 3 by t for the same range, okay. So this means if we integrate, we will find it as, that is 0 to t or 0 to t by 3, we can write it as root 3 by t dt. If we solve it, what we will get is integration is given by root 3 by t is constant, and integration will result again 3 by t. So we will get s11 is given by, that is if we solve it, so we will get root of 3 by t. So s11 is root 3 by t. Now we can substitute s11 here, and we will get g2t. G2t is given by the second intermediate function, g2t is given by s2t minus, so we have s11 that is root 3 by t by 3 and phi 1t is root 3 by t. So this is phi 1t, this is root 3 by t ranging from 0 to t by 3. So we have, so if we simplify it, this will be cancelled out and we will having 1 after cancellation. This means we have g2t given by s2t minus 1 ranging from 0 to t by 3. This means what is s2t? S2t we can see here, it is from 0 to 2t by 3. From 0 to 2t by 3, the value is 1. So 0 to s2t is given by 0 to 2t by 3 and value is 1. Now we have to subtract this with the quantity. Again, it is amplitude is 1 ranging from 0 to t by 3. So what we will get? The subtraction will result you from 0 to t by 3, we don't have any signal. So subtraction will be resulted as from t by 3 to 2 t by 3, the value will be equals to 1 and this will be the g2t. Now we can find the basis function, that is g2t. The second basis function phi 2t is given by g2t divided by energy of under root the energy of g2t. This means 0 to t g2 square t dt. But we know that g2t is given by from t by 3 to 2t by 3, we have the value that is 1. So 1, it is ranging from t by 3 to 2t by 3, we have the value, and under root of its energy, energy is again 1 0 t by 3 to 2t by 3 and it is 1 square dt. So if we solve it, we will get it as, that is phi 2t, that is given by 1 ranging from t by 3 to 2t by 3 and integration of 1 will be t, and this means it is upper limit minus lower limit, that is 2t by 3 minus t by 3. So this means it is given by 1 and t by 3 up to 2t by 3. So we will be having, so if we solve it, so 2t by 3 minus t by 3 will be simply t by 3. So we are getting under root of, so under root of t by 3. So under root of t by 3 we are getting, because we have the under root here. So if we solve it, we are getting the second orthonormal basis function, that is phi 2t, that is given by root of 3 by t ranging from t by 3 to 2t by 3. So this is how we got the second orthonormal basis function, and we can plot the second orthonormal basis function phi 2t given by root of 3 by t, that is ranging from t by 3, we don't have anything here, t by 3 to 2t by 3. So this will be the second orthonormal basis function. Now for the third orthonormal basis function, the intermediate function, third intermediate function, g3t is given by h3t minus summation j is equals to 1 to I minus 1 Sij phi j t. Substituting the value of I, will get it as, that is s3t, that is summation I equals to 3 here. So this means I minus 1. So 3 minus 1 will be 2. So j is varying from 1 to 2. S 3 means I x 3 j and phi j t. So if we expand it, what we will get is s 3 t minus, now substituting I equals to 1 here. So s 3 1 phi 1 t. Substituting I j equals to 2. So substituting j equals to 2, s 3 2 phi 2 t. Now first we have to find the coefficient of s 3 1, then we have to find the coefficient of s 3 2, and we have to substitute in this expression. We will get it as, we are getting s 3 1 that is given by integration from 0 to t s 3 t into phi 1 t and dt. So this means s 3 into phi 1. So what we will get? S 3 is given by, that is t by 3 to t, we are having the value 1. So we are having t by 3 from t by 3 to t, we are having the value 1, that will be s 3 t. Okay. And phi 1 t is ranging from 0 to, phi 1 t is ranging from 0 to t by 3. So the product will be equals to 0. As you can see here, phi 1 t we have solved here, it is ranging from 0 to t by 3. So we don't have any component, so this means this component will be equals to, so multiplication will result to you 0. So this means S31 will be equals to 0. And what is S32? Finding S32, that is given by integration from 0 to t S3t phi 2t dt. Okay. What is S3t? S3t is given by t by 3 to t. Okay. So S3t is given by t by 3 to t, we have the value 1. And what is phi 2? Phi 2 is given by, that is ranging from t by 3 to t by 3. T by 3 to 2t by 3, we are having the value which is root of t by 3. Root of phi 2 is root 3 by t. Okay, that is phi 2 t. Now if we substitute here, what we will get? So if we multiply these, the multiplication will result as root of 3 by t. So it is given by ranging from, that is t by 3 to 2t by 3, but we have the limit, so it will be around 0.6. So we'll ranging from t by 3 to 2t by 3, and the product will be root of 3 by t dt. So further solving it, what we will get? We will get it as, that is root of 3 by t, integration is from, so integration will result t, so upper limit minus lower limit. So what we will get? That is t by 3, so root 3 by t multiplied by t by 3. So what we will get? Root of 3 by t. So S32 is given by, that is under root of 3 by t. Now we substitute, because S31 is 0, so you have only two components, that is G3t. So G3t is given by S3t. So S3t we can draw, and we have to substitute, we have to find it. So we have to substitute here, we have to find this quantity, that is S3t into phi 2. So S32 into phi 2t. So what we will get? S3t is root of 3 by t. And what is phi 2? Phi 2 is given by, here we have the phi 2, it is again root by root 3 by t. And what we will get? It's t by 3, not 3 by t, 3 by t. So what we will get? So it is t by 3 multiply by root, so it will be get 1. So this means 1 for the range, that is from t by 3 to 2t by 3. T by 3 to 2t by 3. So what we will get? We will get, that is, first we have to find what is S3t. What is S3t? As you can see, S3t is given by, S3t is from t by 3 to t, we have the value 1. From t by 3 to t, we are having the value 1. So we can write minus the product. So product is that is given by 1, that is ranging from t by 3 to 2t by 3. So that will be 1. So if you subtract these two, what we will get? So t by 3 to 2t by 3 will be cancelled out. So this area will be cancelled out, and what will left is from 2t by 3 to t will be having the function that is g3t. So we can find the third orthonormal basis function, that is phi3t, that is given by g3t divided by energy of g3t, that is 0 to t g3 square t dt. So what is g3t? G3t is given by the 1, so it is 1 ranging from 2t by 3 to t, and energy under root of its energy, so it is from ranging from 2t by 3 to t, and the value is 1 whole square dt. So this means we will get the third orthonormal basis function, that is given by 1 ranging from 2t by 3 to t divided by under root of the integration of 1 will be simply t, so upper limit 2t3 minus lower limit upper limit is t minus 2t by 3. So the subtraction will result, that is 3t minus 2t will be t by 3. So integration, that is, it will result it as under root of 3 by t ranging from, because 1 multiplied by this will be having this, that is 2t by 3 to t. So we got the three orthonormal basis function. Fourth orthonormal basis function does not exist. So this means phi 4t does not exist. So it will, you can see it is equal to 0. So we have only three orthonormal basis function, phi 1t, phi 2t, phi 3t, and so these are the three orthonormal basis function because they are forming the linear combinations. This means n is less than m, where the number of signals is 4. So this 3 is less than 4. So this conditions we have fulfilled. So in this lecture we have discussed about the Gram-Schmidt orthonormalization procedure, and we have solved one example how to solve the Gram-Schmidt orthonormalization procedure scheme. So here I am going to stop this lecture. Thank you.